Okay, I'll go ahead and get started. So let's start by settling the body in a stable, comfortable, upright position. So we keep our feet flat and our back straight. Trying to think of a column of light going from the tailbone to the top of the back of the head. Wanting that to be perfectly straight. So we try to maintain an awareness of not slouching or leaning. Our eyes are gently closed or slightly open. Hands are in the lap, right over left, with the palms upturned and the thumbs gently touching. Our gaze is unfocused and downward. We also try to let go of rigidity in the body, letting it fall into place naturally. So briefly scan and notice if you're holding unnecessary tension. And try to intentionally relax into the posture. Then try to feel as though you move away from the outside world and your awareness moves inward, feeling more self-contained. Losing interest also in thoughts of the past, plans for the future, trying to concentrate your awareness in the present moment, using the physical sensation of the air, passing into and back out of the tip of the nostrils. Noticing quickly when anything that isn't that sensation has arisen in the mind. And then without judgment or frustration, lifting your attention up from that distraction and gently but firmly placing it back on that present moment, physical sensation, repeating that process again and again, trying to hold your attention to that one physical sensation without distraction. And then when the mind feels more calm, try to generate a broad motivation. Thinking that your time and your effort is the vehicle of your own inner development, inner transformation. Tapping into your own potential more and more, and wanting to develop that potential mainly to expand your capacity to be of greater and greater benefit to sentient beings. Seeing yourself as the recipient of incredible kindness in this life and all previous lives. Wanting to repay that kindness by developing those good qualities. Then we'll contemplate the third immeasurable compassion. So the verse is, how wonderful it would be if all sentient beings were free from suffering and its causes. May they be free from suffering and its causes. I myself will cause them to be free from suffering and its causes. Please, Guru Buddha, bless me to be able to do so. So we'll focus first on the immeasurable wish. How wonderful it would be if all sentient beings were free from suffering and its causes. So think of the myriad ways in which you yourself meet unwished for circumstances. From the very minor frustrations to things that are more intense, more difficult. And try to think that all sentient beings are just like me. Wanting only happiness, but again and again, coming up against situations that are painful. So try to make as many examples, 3 or 4 examples, and try to really feel that there's nothing unique about those obstacles, those sufferings. Countless other sentient beings are right now experiencing similar or more intense levels of suffering. Then try to feel a sense of the benefit if you yourself were completely relieved of all of that suffering. And also try to generalize that out to all sentient beings. There's also nothing unique about that benefit. Every sentient being would equally appreciate and is equally deserving of being completely free of that suffering. And then try to connect with the aspiration of may they be free from suffering. And then not only may they be free from suffering, but may I cause them to be free from suffering. So here, to the extent that you are comfortable, try to focus on taking on the suffering of other sentient beings to relieve them of that suffering. You can think about experiencing your own difficulties as a proxy for the suffering of others, and think by my experiencing of these difficulties, may all sentient beings be relieved of suffering. And transform your relationship to obstacles. Thinking of them as the vehicle to overcome the self-cherishing mind. By experiencing them for the benefit of sentient beings. You can also visualize several sentient beings in front of you representing different realms. The hell realm, preta realm, animal realm, human realm, upper realm. And think that the various sufferings of each realm that you take on to yourself to relieve the beings there of those sufferings. Thank you. So in whatever way you're comfortable with, try to focus on taking on the suffering of sentient beings. And then the last line, please, Guru Buddha, bless me to be able to do so. So in whatever way you want to think about the energy of enlightenment, something higher than oneself, think that you connect with that energy of universal love and compassion and wisdom, and that due to the force of that, the blessing of that energy, that oneself and all sentient beings have the realization of genuine, spontaneous, uncontrived compassion, arising in their mind. And then when you're ready, we'll come back together. And we'll dedicate. So think of the motivation that you established. And think that by engaging in these contemplations, you've actualized your motivation and that the positive energy of that is something that you offer freely for the benefit of all sentient beings without exception. Thinking, may it ripen in whatever way is beneficial for sentient beings. May it serve as a cause and condition for all sentient beings to eventually achieve the state of enlightenment. The only way in which they could be completely free of all suffering. May it serve as a cause for enlightenment in one's own mind, to give oneself the tools and the ability to benefit sentient beings perfectly. And may this positive energy pacify any obstacles to the Guru's long life. And may it cause oneself and all sentient beings to come under the care of the enlightened beings in this moment, until each and every sentient being achieves enlightenment. Thank you.